All right, my friends, welcome back. So today I'm gonna be doing a greenhouse project. We're gonna be putting a door on the greenhouse. So currently what we got is the zippered doors on either side of the greenhouse. I'm just gonna be replacing one side with a swing door. And the zippers are working fine, but you know, we're about to get really busy in this greenhouse as winter approaches. I plan on doing quite a bit of growing inside, so I don't wanna have to be fiddling with those zippers every single day. All right, so as you can see, I've already started getting the doorway framed up. And, you know, I came out here earlier today and I was just thinking, how can I do this? So the main objective before I began to build out this doorway was the cost. This greenhouse is very low cost, and I don't want to spend half the cost of the greenhouse on the doorway. So, you know, if this was to cost me $100 or so, it'd kind of defeat the purpose. If you agree with those sentiments, go ahead and smash that thumb button for me right now, because I'm trying to keep this project low cost, not just for myself, but for anybody watching. I want to show you what's possible, what you can do on a dime. So all the materials that I'm utilizing for this build are items that I already had on hand. So no need to go out of pocket if you've got, you know, wood and fencing and stuff like that laying around. Get creative. So I encourage anybody watching this video today, if you get some ideas from this project, to make it your own and try to utilize whatever materials you might have on site at your place so you can lower your costs as well. So starting out here, we've got some 2x4s. So I had to figure out how I was gonna frame this opening. So the first step here was to frame out the doorway. So I've got a couple 2x4s here and I need to trim these down. I'm about to do that with my Sawzall. But you know, the more I was thinking about it, there was really no need to go heavy duty on the door. Overall, this is a lightweight greenhouse, so a lightweight door is gonna fit in just perfectly. So what I did here, because I don't wanna actually puncture through any of the covering here, I plan on taking this off in the summer, putting on a shade cloth so that I can extend its life. So I don't wanna puncture through here anything that can begin to become ratty, you know, and the holes spread. So I had some of this perforated hanger strap on hand. This stuff is really cheap and useful for so many things. And what I did is just simply loop around the frame of the greenhouse here and screw it in to the board, both at the top and the bottom. And yes, there's still some movement here. It's not too rigid. And I may look into actually putting some added support on the outside with a fence post or something if need be. But I'm thinking that this is gonna work out just fine. What I'm gonna do actually is use a section of cattle panel as the doorway. And it's a rather small piece, so it shouldn't be all that heavy. And then I'm gonna put some greenhouse plastic over that. So it's gonna be lightweight all in all. So once I get the door installed, what I plan to do is go around with some Gorilla tape and seal this up. If in the future I need to remove it, I can just hit it with a heat gun and it'll pull off rather easy. If it doesn't stick solidly to the wood, I can just tack in some nails. So that's gonna shore everything up and get rid of all the little air gaps. And I'm just using these 1¼ exterior screws. So my idea is to take some of this hanger strap here and make little hinges. I'm gonna attach it to the wood onto the cattle panel so that we can have that swing action going. So I've got these cattle panels here ready to go, several of them, to use in the garden. What I'm going to do is use these bolt cutters to cut it down to size. All right, so that's going to work.
So a quick interjection here, hindsight's always 20/20, but later on in the build I had realized that it would have been best to actually leave at least a couple more inches of the 2x4 protruding, as I'll be installing a little overhang over the top here, as I had to fill this gap in between the 2x4 and the door, and I don't want water rushing in between there. So if I had this protruding a little higher, it'd be easy to screw right into it, but instead it was getting in the way of the door. So basically I just used the same piece I cut and added a couple inches and then a couple 3-inch screws to screw that in on either side. But if you're thinking about a similar build, just keep that in mind because we need the clearance above the door here.
All right, so I'm just going to cut out a bunch of these little hinges from the hanger strap. This stuff's pretty sharp, so you want to be careful. All right, so I got a couple of these little T-posts, and I'm gonna pound these in on both sides here just to help to brace everything together. See, we're lined up pretty much right in the center there. All right, we're pretty much there. Just need to put on some greenhouse plastic, and I'm just going to basically wrap this up and use some Gorilla tape to attach it. So I've had this for quite some time. 6 mil, 10 foot by 100 foot. You can get this in the painter section over at Home Depot.
One is very thick.
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty much it, my friends. That went together rather easy. Nice and clean and flush. Would have looked nicer if I put clear tape there. I could change that out. But we got the little door opener there. Now, what I still want to do here is I want to secure this part of the greenhouse to the post, like I mentioned earlier. So I'm going to run some Gorilla tape down this end and down this end. So that's clean. Now I'm just gonna switch out these pieces of black tape with some clear tape. All right, so I'm gonna install a little overhang over the top of the greenhouse here just to keep any water from getting trapped there behind the rolled up door and then falling down the inside of the greenhouse door. So I'm gonna accomplish that by using this piece of sheet metal here. This is just some aluminum scrap sheet metal, easily pliable. If you didn't have something like this, you could even use cardboard wrapped in greenhouse plastic. And just like that, that's not going anywhere. So there it is. After a couple small revisions here, we've got the overhang installed to help shed the water. And I also put a second latch here up top. Now I can come out here at the start of the day, open up the door. This is going to be really nice.
So not too shabby, especially seeing that I didn't have to purchase anything, just used materials here on site. Looks pretty clean. I like the difference it made putting the clear tape on there. Well, that's going to do it for now, my friends. If you liked this episode, found it interesting or entertaining, be sure to smash that like button. If you haven't already, consider subscribing and smashing that bell notification so you never miss a future episode. I've got some really cool projects coming up involving this greenhouse. You're not going to want to miss it. Some really cool stuff. So with that, I want to thank you all for watching. Have yourself a great rest of the day. Until next time, this is Dan from plantabundance.com. Take care. I'll be talking to you again soon. Thank you.